And now, Fight fans, we are set to go with this bout scheduled for four rounds in the heavyweight division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing black trunks trimmed in red, he weighed an officially 281 pounds. He steps into the ring tonight for the 10th time as a professional, hailing from Lansing, Michigan, here is Tommy Washington! And across the ring, his opponent stands, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing red with gold, he weighed in 286 pounds. As a professional in one bout, he has a victory, that coming by way of knockout, hailing from Beijing, China. Here is the undefeated Tai Shaw! Referee in charge of the action is Jack Reeves.
I gave you both instruction in the dress room. I just want to remind you, listen and obey my commands at all time. Protect yourself at all time. Good luck to both of you. Back.
One thing we should say before the start of this fight that is different for Tai Shaw, since his last fight, he has employed the services of a very great trainer, Buddy McGirt, who says that, you know, Tai Shaw lacking in fundamentals and was very green when he came to him, couldn't even hit the speed bag, but he has now basically begun working with him on those areas and trying to pick him up in terms of his fundamentals going into this fight.
Ready?
As we get going in the heavyweight division, that means a lot tonight. 7 foot, 286-pound Tai Shaw with the red trunks against 6 foot, 281-pound Tommy Washington out of Michigan in the black and red.
What Tai Shaw did show in his opening bout was a very hard left jab, but he would throw them one at a time. He might throw one, and then you wouldn't see another one for 30, 45 seconds. And McGirt wants him to definitely throw more of those jabs. It'll be a good weapon for him.
Tai Shaw from Beijing, now living in Glendale, California. It's just so massive.
Well, you're right, turn around.
You mentioned we were talking to Buddy McGirt in the fighter meeting, but he said, I have to teach him everything. It's almost like an 8-year-old walking in, learning to fight for the first time. Well, because Tai Shaw has no amateur background experience in boxing. With a solid mountain.
Well, and he's named after a mountain, Tai Shaw, which he has ascended, by the way.
The Tai Shaw Mountain in China. Climbed it. He said, that's it. That's my name.
Now living in Glendale, California, has his wife and child here, and training with Buddy McGirt in Burbank, which for those of you around the nation don't know, that is basically right next door to each other. So he can train and go home to mama.
To put this in perspective, Tai Shaw wears a size 18-foot shoe and 22-ounce gloves that were custom ordered for him. The headgear was custom ordered for him. Story goes that he went for his first physical. Doctor asked him if he had ever had a concussion. He said, no, I've never been hit in my head. Nobody's ever reached here with overhand right.
Tommy Washington has not fought in 6 years. The reason being, he was incarcerated for five of those. Very open about that. Hopes he's learned some lessons from that. He's looking to make something of his life. Well, he still can. He's only 28 years old. Tommy said, I got to get inside. Hasn't been able to do that yet.
Hit with a left hook to the body of Tai Shaw. You saw another 7-footer before, haven't you?
Yeah, that was the guy that we talked about a little bit, Valuev, who was a champion not so long ago, had a heavyweight belt, WBA heavyweight belt, and did fight good fighters. I mean, he fought Evander Holyfield. There's
down.
Washington down from a right hand.
Four, look at me, please. Five, you getting up? Six, seven, you getting up? Eight, nine, ten.
Mike Reese was asking him the question, and the crowd's not buying it. They don't feel that he was hit hard.
Well, there you see Tai Shaw. It's a knockout in the first round over Tommy Washington. He jumps on the ropes, and hopefully the ring doesn't break.
He had a little trouble getting through those ropes. He might try going over the top of them next time when he gets into the ring.
Tai Shaw, an interesting story that Buddy McGirt was telling us that he expects at least a couple years to actually get some knowledge of what this fighter could be. We know he's strong, we know he's powerful. And only a second pro fight, another knockout.
Well, he says that he's enjoying life in the United States. It's been very good to him, and that he's met a lot of good people who are going to try and guide his career. One of those being Buddy McGirt that we talked about right next to him. Buddy's trained a lot of champions. We'll take a look at the knockout here and see if we can decipher what happened. Washington had been dominated up to that point. There were the two left jabs, a follow-up right, and then a right to the back of the head. It was that right to the back of the head which put him down. Crowd thought he missed with that punch, but he did not. He did hit the back of the head with it. Valua, Tyshawn is a work in progress, let's face it. And I think everyone should cut the guy a little slack here at the start of his career with no amateur fights at all. I did see him in an MMA fight a couple of years ago against Bob Sapp. You remember Big Bob
against
Sapp?
Big Bob Sapp, yeah. That was towards the end of Sapp's career in Japan.
And he did knock out Bob Sapp. And there's Tyshawn, who's hoping to make things happen. And as I said at the beginning here, it's going to just be intrigue around him, surrounding him.
A lot of questions.
Yeah, and he'll have to answer the questions.
A lot of power, though, when he does connect. As Buddy McGirt was telling us, those hands, when they are working the mitts. Buddy McGirt saying he had to teach him how to actually use a speed bag. Let's go to our ring announcer, Joe Martinez.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at the official time. 2 minutes, 35 seconds, round number one. Referee Jack Reese reaches the count of 10 for your winner by KO and still undefeated, Tyshawn.